It was a star-studded occasion of Hollywood glamour that was hosted by Prince Charles, featured a house music DJ and concluded with an impressive fireworks display outside an historic 17th century venue. And Prince Harry and Meghan Markle's wedding reception is also said to have featured a naughty speech from best man Prince William, a thanks from Meghan to the royal family for welcoming her in and a surprise from compere James Corden. The dinner party at Frogmore House in Windsor Great Park came after a multicultural and US-influenced wedding featuring an astonishing host of Hollywood guests including George Clooney, Oprah Winfrey, and the Beckhams, the likes of which Britain's royals and the millions watching have never seen before. Later on the reception, Harry's favorite house tracks curated by DJ Sam Totally, who also performed at Pippa Middleton's wedding, and a Drinks of the World themed bar. And their first dance was said to have been Whitney Houston's I Wanna Dance With Somebody, giving a further nod to Meghan's American heritage. Also on the menu were candy floss and dirty burgers as midnight snacks, while one source reported a cocktail featuring ginger and rum was on the menu as a cheeky nod to Harry's red hair, named When Harry Met Meghan. The sit-down dinner was organic, sourced at the request of Prince Charles, and the light bite canapes were themed spring meets summer. The meal, paid for by the Prince of Wales, ran from 7:30 p.m. to around 10 p.m. There were said to have been naughty speeches from William and a joint effort from Tom Skippy Inskip and Tom Van Straubenzee. Meghan is also thought to have thanked the royal family for welcoming her in. Guests are also understood to have returned to London late last night for an after-after party at celebrity favourite Chiltern Firehouse in Marylebone. Another party had been planned in a soundproofed private home in Chelsea. In the afternoon, a grinning Harry is said to have turned to his guests, asking, "Can anyone play the piano?" before Sir Elton John gave a moving medley of four hits, "Your Song," "Tiny Dancer," "Circle of Life" and "I'm Still Standing." The newlyweds shared tears, laughter, and a passionate kiss in front of their hundreds of VIP guests dominated by Hollywood stars including the Clooneys, the Beckhams, Idris Elba, Oprah Winfrey, Tom Hardy and James Corden. Missing from the day was Meghan's father Thomas Markle, who was in Mexico after pulling out just days ago due to ill health, following an extraordinary week that saw infighting between her estranged family, her nephews turning up to London uninvited and her only relative at the wedding being her mother Doria Ragland. Meghan became the first mixed-race member of the royal family in an extraordinary journey for a girl born in LA to a white father and African-American mother who fought her way through the tough world of show business to land a plum role in the TV series Suits. Harry and Meghan's big day couldn't have been more different than royal weddings of the past, especially because the prince was visibly emotional throughout, and guests suggested it was the most diverse major event in the Queen's 66-year reign. Around 200 guests joined the couple at the evening event at the 17th century Frogmore Mansion in the grounds of Windsor Castle, where Meghan, wearing an aquamarine ring which once belonged to Princess Diana, made a speech to guests.